prospects for business in Ayodhya had started to look up in anticipation since the verdict last year. But months later, little has moved on the ground, and COVID-19 has added more to it. But Prime Minister Narendra Modi, on the other hand, believes that the construction of the Grand Ram Temple will change the economy of the region by creating new opportunities and providing jobs for the people living there. Asserting that a new era of development had begun with the construction of Ram Temple in Ayodhya, Prime Minister said, "Whenever we have embraced the name of Ram, there has been development."
इस मंदिर के बनने के बाद अयोध्या की सिर्फ भव्यता ही नहीं बढ़ेगी, इस क्षेत्र का पूरा अर्थतंत्र भी बदल जाएगा। यहां हर क्षेत्र में नए अवसर बनेंगे, हर क्षेत्र में अवसर बढ़ेंगे, पूरी दुनिया से लोग यहां आएंगे, पूरी दुनिया प्रभु राम और माता जानकी का दर्शन करने आएगी, कितना कुछ बदल जाएगा यहां।
So there are expectations that the construction of the Ram Mandir might get completed in about 3 to 3.5 years and the business prospects in and around the city will get enhanced.
Now, it's like a new morning for the Ayodhya, and now the people will come. So we are in the process of creating a huge infrastructure support in Ayodhya to support the national and international tourists who will be coming in the near future in Ayodhya. We have taken the various projects worth rupees 130 crore in Ayodhya. That includes development of Ayodhya, Naya Ghat, Ram Ki Pairi, Hanuman Gadi, Uttar Ghat, Jhumki Ghat, Harishchandra Ghat. There are so many ghats which are being developed because a huge number of tourists come. We are planning to develop some other things also. Then the yoga university in Ayodhya, there will be yoga, and then the cultural university, we are in the process of making a DPR for the Ramayana and Ramalila Academy in Ayodhya also. Along with that, we will develop a library, we will develop an industry to make the attire for Ramalila. Right now, Ramalila doesn't have the proper attire industry. There are some in and around Delhi from where the Ramlila Mandalis get their dresses and other things. So in Ayodhya, we will be developing the dress and attire industry for Ramlila also. That will be there. Then we are developing a souvenir industry also along with parallelly. So they can take along with, they can take the holy water of Sariu along with them in a jewelry box type of thing we are creating. And then we are creating Ramcharitmanas in a jewelry box, which then so many other things are being created for the souvenir purpose, so that the people may take it along with the memory of their travel to Ayodhya.
Experts do believe that many industries are looking forward to Ayodhya city as a big opportunity. Not only we are talking about FMCG goods, agarbatti, dhoop, roli or chandan, or even flowers industries for Lord Ram, but there will be a plenty of business activities which would further boost tourism. So as per data released by UP Tourism, in 2019, out of the 54.6 crore tourists who had visited the state, 2.1 crore tourists had visited Ayodhya. This year, those numbers were expected to be surpassed during the initial celebration itself. However, COVID-19 played its part. It is believed that Ayodhya is likely to wean away many tourists and devotees from other religious sites such as Mathura. In fact, the state government has already approved a 640 crore for its development of an international airport over 285 acres at Ayodhya to attract domestic and foreign tourists in large numbers. So having an airport would not only uplift the city's economy but generate higher number of jobs too.
Right now, the tourists who come here, normally they think that there are 2-3 things only which can be seen here, and most important things is they come and see. It's a one day visit right now. They come to Lucknow, or if they are coming from Delhi or from some other, by the airway, the connecting near airport is Lucknow. They see Hanumangadi, Sri Ram Janmabhoomi Sthal, and at the most, the people who are interested in Aarti, they go in Aarti, they see Aarti and they come back. So most of the people don't stay in Ayodhya, and they are interested in mythological places of Ayodhya, but since they don't know, or the organized tour for that is not available, so they are not able to cover those things. So we have worked on that, and now we will be working on a development of walkthrough circuit, heritage walk, and it will be about 3-4 day circuit tour in Ayodhya, so that when the people who come there, they take the glimpses of crafts which are being made here. They take the cuisine taste of the typical Avadhi cuisine taste for which it is famous, and they will get the taste of culture also. We have made a round the year calendar of the culture events in Ayodhya, and along with this heritage walk, we will be adding the cultural festivals also, so that the people will have the glimpse of the cultural festival in Ayodhya all throughout the year in different calendar seasons.
Apart from all this, many hoteliers are likely to build hotels and guest houses in Ayodhya to accommodate the tourists which would be coming in the city from across the world. Also, restaurant chains and food franchises of popular companies might also try their luck in Ayodhya and are expected to have a great business platform.
We are developing the land bank along with the housing department and the urban development department of the state. And in this, about 600 acres of land has been identified, which will be developed, and those will be allotted to the developers also for the private development. We have planned the establishment of 5 5-star hotels, minimum 10 3-4-star hotels, and 50 dormitory dharamsalas type of things. And on all 4 directions of Ayodhya, we are developing the multi-level parking also. And then we will be able to run the battery-operated cars in Ayodhya. So it will be like some golf cart. People will come, leave their vehicle at one destination. And this is also in the energy-based city, that it should not buy any energy from outsourcing. So produce the energy, whatever the energy is required. So we are working on that. All the drainage will be underground, and we will be developing STP for that. All these things are in pipeline. So in addition to Sri Ram Janmabhoomi Mandir, which is the mandate of the Temple Construction Trust, the trust will be making the temple. But the government is in development of the infrastructure support. If you see the parikrama, there are 3 parikramas in Ayodhya. One is one kosi, another is panch kosi, then is 14 kosi, and another 4th one is the 84 kosi parikrama. And people do come for this parikrama. The 84 kosi parikrama covers 4-5 districts. So we'll be developing the infrastructure support in all vicinity.
Experts believe that once the people of Ayodhya get enough of the income to consume, they will save money, and their expenses might in more include an outflow of business in the district. They might shift their utility from necessary to luxurious items that will again result in sale and purchase. So with the historic judgment, the price of farmland has gone up by more than 30%. Many low-wage workers are believing that they might get employed in the real estate sector that might boom across the city and also across the Ram Mandir premises, which would in turn generate revenue and opportunities for them.
In fact, the tourism is the sector where the maximum number of employment is being generated, be it direct or indirect. Once the travel flow will increase, the tourist number will increase. And once they start staying there, right now they the international tourist or even the national tourist, those who have the capacity to pay, they normally don't stay there. They do come in the morning and they leave in the evening. Once they start staying there in Ayodhya, then naturally they will expand.
Though the government has announced a slew of measures for the temple town, but for now, it seems to be largely wait and watch.